You know the best thing about YouTube is whenever you have a question, you can get an answer.
And you know this, man!
Today's video is answering a question about one of my favorite pieces of gear in my studio, which is the OBSBOT Tail Air. The Tail Air is a really incredible PTZ, pan, tilt, zoom, pan, tilt, zoom camera that you can use for your studio. I primarily use it as an overhead shot, so when I go to do something like this. Now, in that question, it came up that the person, let me get the name right. It says Rainsane 518 said, I got this camera and the menu how to set the thing up is really not easy. I have no idea how to set it from 4K to whatever and how to set the frame rate. Well, we're going to dive in. The first thing we're going to do is jump over here and I'm going to pull up my iPhone camera because I believe they're talking about the iPhone app, which is here, but this is the OBSBOT camera up there. So on the iPhone app, here, let me hit the focus button on my little remote. Okay, on the iPhone app, what you want to do is in the bottom corner down here, there's these three red dots. And when you press on those three red dots, you have a whole bunch of settings in here. You want to scroll down to where it says media settings. And we're going to press that. Media settings is going to allow you to click here to adjust the frame rate. And you can use 24, 25, 29, 97, straight 30. You can pick which type of encoder you want, H.264, H.265. I like H.265. You're going to set your bit rate. I'm going to almost always set this sucker to high. Ooh, wrong fat fingers. There you go. I'm going to always leave it on high. And then you can set your resolution. So right now you can do 720, 1080p, or 4K. So I have it set for 4K. Now, currently, this camera is set up in what's known as the NDI mode. NDI, that's a difficult one to explain, but not really. You know, you have a baby monitor or a ring camera. It's basically the camera can send the signal over the Wi-Fi to get to anywhere else as long as you know the proper IP address for that camera. It's basically the way to say it. So I have it currently set up in the NDI mode. And if you do that, then you can also make those changes too, because the NDI mode or the RTP, SRT, they're all similar type of processes. You can set what is the frame rate when you're sending it that way. So for instance, I could click on here and adjust whether it's 720, 1080, or 4K. And the reason for that is if you're doing something like streaming in a place where the network isn't that dope, you can make that change, right? If you go somewhere the network is solid, then you could do 4K for the recording and 4K for the transmission. So I'm not sure which of the two settings that Rainsane 518 was looking for, but understand that you can definitely do both inside of here. So let's go back and take a look. You also have the ability to select when you're using the HDMI output if you want to switch it over. Now it's going to tell you that recording using the NDI RT or SRT and HDMI only selecting one simultaneous, you can't do both, right? So you got to decide whether you want to come out of the HDMI input or over the network that way, in which case it doesn't really matter for me, but you'll see now that it has switched over here on the record setting. And you also found out that the 3D printer is done. So let's come back over here. I'll show you something that's really cool in a second. Basically, it's all you need to do for the iOS output. This is going to be the same probably on the Android version of the phone. I believe I have a full video walkthrough in the channel on how to get through all of the other segments of this app. But if there's any questions, of course, just ask. But the main thing we're looking for is in this media settings panel, right? So if you have any questions whatsoever on the iOS app, just please let me know. I'm pretty sure I have a whole video about that process. But that's it. It's in the media settings. So once again, if you're, you know, here on the main screen looking at the camera, go down to the bottom corner and press the three dots. You want to make sure you get it over to the media setting, and then you can select your record settings and select which one you want. I'll put it back because that's what I use. You can select your NDI settings and you can select your HDMI settings right there. Now let's jump over to the desktop app real quick, and I'm going to give you guys an opportunity to see how that one works. This is actually cool. First thing we do is do a little live demo mode here on the eCam so you can see how I record this video. But this is the OBSBOT Center app for the macOS. And basically here, my first camera showing is the Tail Air. And there's a couple different places you can do this. You can click on the video preview, which will pop this guy up. And right here on the bottom, there's a little gearbox. And you can select your various outputs there. And then you can select whether you're doing landscape in case you want to do verticals for, say, TikTok, Instagram, or YouTube Shorts or something of that nature. Again, high. These settings are being, whatever you set in the phone pulls over to the desktop. So if I set something here on the desktop, it would show up in the phone because the settings are stored in the actual camera. You have access to adjust your audio settings if that's important to you. And then you could also go in here and do some of your, this is designed for like a remote control protocol. We don't really need to mess with that. So let's just keep it simple today. So I'm going to show you another place to get to that. Just in case, is at the very top here, there is a little bitty gear icon. Let me close this. There's a little bitty gear icon. You can select that gear icon and you get the same action. You would basically select the camera that you want to mess with, click on the output, and it's all there. And you can specify which one you want. Now, if you happen to use another OBSBOT camera, say the Tiny, this is the Tiny 2 Lite, it's the exact same setup. We're just going to click on the little gearbox here, and then I have it set for 4K 30, but also you could click on this guy here, and you can see that it's set for 4K 30. What's really cool about this desktop app is it acts very much similar to this remote control that I have. So right now I have the camera set to look at myself, but if I press the preset 2, it'll do a little switch over, and you can see the 3D printer over there. So if I swing it back, look at me, and it can show it. So I can, you know, if I want to see what the printer is doing or something of that nature, I'm also able to switch back to the other camera if I was using it. I'm not using it for a switcher. I use Ecamm as a switcher, but you have access. And same thing here. I have the various presets. So this is my first one. And then I can have a second preset, which would be looking at like something over here, or I could rock the third preset, which would look at something over there. So these are really, really cool cameras and why I really love them. I tell people all the time, if I was going to rebuild my studio today, I probably would use like three of these OBSBOT cameras as opposed to these Sonys and stuff that I had prior, which were just, you know, cost a lot more. So at this moment in time, they're really beautiful. And just in case you don't have the desktop software over here, this is the OBSBOT website. And all you need to do, if you haven't done so already, is come to the main page, click on resources, and resources will bring you to the download tab. The download tab will get you over. You select whichever camera you want. In this case, they all use the same web center. So I'll use the Tail Air because that's what we're talking about today. And you're going to want to download this app right here, OBSBOT Center. That'll pull down what you need. If you need an updated version of the app for your iPhone or iOS, then that's this top one here, which is the OBSBOT. Start. Rainstein 518. I hope we got your question answered. If you have any further questions, comments, or feedback, drop them down below. And if you haven't already picked up an OBSBOT, telling you, they're amazing. Even when we were on the site, that new one they got on the front page, the Me Too, absolutely incredible camera at like, I think $129 or something like that. It is phenomenal for what it is. If you really like this video, I appreciate this video, go ahead and press that subscribe button. If you'd like to join the community of Gen X creators out here doing that thing, go ahead and press the join button and become a member and come and hang out with us over here at the LGL squad. And I am on a mission to get to 20,000 by the end of the year. So if you know somebody who needs to see this type of content or need a swift kick in the butt so they can start doing that thing, go ahead and send them a link to the channel. I appreciate it. Leave me a message below if you got anything else you want to see. Now the algorithm is going to show you another video they think you should watch, and I agree with them.
I need to know everything, who and the what and the where, I need everything. Trust me, I hear what you're saying, but act like it's new what you're telling me. I'm curious, George, I hop in the Porsche, a 5 and a horse, I'm ready for war, I'm coming for throws, to turn to a ghost, I need to know everything. Now you'll be surprised at the info you get, is by letting them talk, so I'm letting them talk. Gotta keep quiet, maneuver inside.